Good morning. Beautiful day the Lord's made for us. We should rejoice and be glad in it. It's good to be a child of the King. Feel blessed to be in God's house this morning. I'm glad you all could join us this morning. Feel that it's needful that we go to the Lord in prayer. We have many needs on our heart this morning, so let's just take them to the Lord. Let's bow our heads, please. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy, your love, and your peace that passeth all understanding. Lord, we're just so grateful for everything that you do in our lives. Lord, we just praise your name for all the healing that you've done, for the strength and the comfort that you give us. Lord, we just pray that you touch and heal those that are still standing in need this morning, Lord. You know each and every one, whether it be a physical need or a spiritual need, Lord. We just pray that you touch according to your sovereign and holy plan, Lord. Lord, we just pray that you be with this service. May it uplift your holy name, and may it let your light, Father, not ours, but your light, shine into the lost and dying world. It's these things we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I do want to say it's good to be back in God's house. I don't know about everybody else that tuned in Wednesday night, but Brother AJ's lesson has been whipping me all week long.
Amen.
And I need it. I need it a lot. And I appreciate him more than he knows. I'm excited about the teaching again this morning. But before we get into that, I believe Sister Jonna has a song for us this morning.
He measured the sea in the palm of his hand. The mountains were placed at his command, and at the sound of his voice, the sun came through. God's big sky. and that same mighty God can take a heart of stone, wash it and cleanse it and make it His own. There's no
First off, I'd just like to start and say it's good to be in God's house this morning.
Amen.
Amen.
I know that a lot of us can't be here right now, but I thank God that the church of the living God is not confined to a building.
Amen.
We are a people. We are God's people.
Amen, bro.
I'd ask that you pray for me because my heart's beating about 200 beats per minute right now. But that's all right.
It's all right, buddy.
So, if you would, turn to Genesis chapter 1. We're going to be talking about creation a little bit this morning.
Yes.
So, in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, it says, first 10 words of the Bible. It says, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth.
Amen.
And I'd like to stop right there because there's so, so much just in that one verse. The first four words, it says, in the beginning, God. In the beginning, God. That's a whole sentence right there. I don't know if you know that, but that's a whole sentence right there. In the beginning, God. I'm not big on listening to messages online or anything, but I just so happened to stumble across a message by the late Reverend Billy Graham, and he pointed something out that I've never thought of before. The Bible's first words, it says, in the beginning, God. See, the Bible never questions God's existence.
Yeah.
It just states it as a fact. God is in the beginning, and God was in the beginning, and He is the beginning, and He will be there at the end, because God is the Alpha and God is
Amen.
Omega. He is the beginning and the end.
Amen, bro.
Okay, so we've established that this God is Alpha and Omega. That's what we've established so far. So secondly, that fourth word, it says God. So we read about in the Bible, throughout the Old and the New Testament, of people worshiping their gods or God. But there's something different if you look closely about this God. See, that God there, the fourth word of the first verse, that God right there, He has a big G.
Amen. Big G.
And that big G means something.
Amen.
See, I think of when they worship the image of Baal, or Moses coming down and the Israelites were worshiping the golden calf. These would be considered little G gods.
Yeah.
Right.
But the little G gods don't just apply to biblical times. They apply, they are still applicable to this very day.
Yeah.
Now,
right.
We may say like, oh, no, I'm not dumb enough to be worshiping a golden calf. But anything that you put before our big G gods is considered a little G god.
Amen.
Whether you realize it or not.
That's right.
Little G gods can Anything that we put before God can be a little g god. For example, what's on the television? If we decide, you know what, I'm going to put what's on that TV before I need to crack open my Bible. Or what's on this phone? And I'm not telling y'all that because I'm holier than thou. I'm telling y'all that because I struggle with that.
Amen.
Whether it's what's on that TV or what's on that phone or how much is in that wallet.
Blessing Lord.
Amen.
Come on. If anything that we put before this big G God is considered a little G God. But that big G, it means something. That means this God is a God placed above all the other little G gods in our life.
Amen.
Blessing Lord.
So we've established that God is the beginning and He is the end. He is Alpha and Omega. Not only is this God the Alpha and Omega, He is a God above all the other gods in our life. Alright, so that's what we've established so far. So going on to the fifth word, it says created. That word right there adds on to this definition that we know so far. It establishes God as a creator. And we know that this verse, it says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the heaven and the earth, which that establishes God as a creator. And we know that God is a very skilled creator, because He created everything in the known universe within a week, and He created everything in the unknown universe for that matter. Atheists like to use the theory, most of y'all probably know this, it's the Big Bang Theory. They believe that out of a gaseous belch in the universe 6 million years ago, everything that we know about, everything that exists, came from a big nothing. Everything came from nothing. I don't know about you, but I don't have enough faith to believe that's true. Because for every creation, we know there has to be a creator.
That's
this phone that's in my pocket, or the phone that you're looking at this message through, or the TV, you know that if you took all the pieces of it apart, and you stuck it in a bag, and you shook it for 6 million years, what are the odds of all of that coming together and being assembled just like it's supposed to be assembled? Even by their own definitions, the Big Bang Theory does not make sense. Because for there to be creation, or whatever they call it, for it to be creation, three things have to exist at the exact same time. There has to be time, there has to be space, and there has to be matter. You can't have space and matter and not know when to put it. You can't have time and matter but no space to put it in. So all of these three things have to happen at the same time. And the Big Bang Theory doesn't even talk about time. It doesn't even talk about, it's just assumed that it's the beginning of time. But in the first 10 words of the Bible, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
That's right.
Amen. So, I guess I just blew that out of the word.
Amen, bro.
That's good, bro.
But we not only know that God is your creator, but God is a very skilled creator, because we know He created, you know, everything in the known universe and everything in the unknown universe. You know, it says He created Lot and created everything on this earth and created us. And after each of His creations, I'm getting ahead of myself here. After each of His creations, He saw what He had created, and He saw that His creation was good. The Bible says that if we read along in Genesis chapter 1. But after each part of His creation, he looked at it, He saw what He had done, and it says that He saw that it was good. But then the sixth day comes along, and God creates humans. And then He takes a step back, and He looks at everything that He's done. And then the Bible says He saw that it was very good.
Amen.
And that the fact that He says it's very good, that means something. Not only is God a creator, and He's a skilled creator, but He's a loving creator. And that...
Yes.
Something when I was reading through this that God gave to me is that not only are we God's creation, God didn't have to create us. If if he never would have created the universe, it would still would have been perfect, because we are flawed and we messed up his creation. But if he wouldn't have created a universe, it still would have been perfect. But God said, no, that's not the way this works. Because we know that God is love.
Amen.
And that love is an action. And love is best expressed towards something. So God created us. He loved us enough just to create us. Because he wanted to express his love for us. And we are his most loved creation.
Amen.
That's awesome just to think about. We are God's most loved creation. The creator of everything in the known universe. We are his most loved creation. And the beauty of that is that it's not something to say, ooh, look at me. Because we are flawed. And not because God created us flawed. Because God is perfect and God knows what he's doing. Because we messed it up when we decided to sin. We've messed up his creation. But God is a loving creator. And so a little over 2,000 years ago, he sent his son down to die for us on a cross so that we would have salvation. And he sent his son, his most, the thing that he valued most, he sent his son down to fix his creation because it had messed itself up. That's awesome to think about. He sent the God that created the entire universe, sent his most loved, he sent his only begotten son to come down and die for us just to fix his creation. And I have an analogy that went along with that, and it's going to be a lot better than the one I had when I was going through this lesson last night, because God found another analogy for me to use. So this is automatically a lot better than the other one that I was going to use. So I had found I was on social media, and I just so happened to stumble across a story. And it's a children's book, and I had never read this children's book before. But it's called, I believe it's called You Are Special, if I'm not mistaken. And what it is there's this town of toys. And these toys, they live and talk and go to work just like we do as humans. And these toys, they have two things that they give out to people. If they have a gold star and they've got a gray dot. So the gold star is, oh, you know what? I like your job. You get a gold star. Or oh, you look talented. Here's a gold star. Or, oh, you look cooler than all the rest of the toys. You get a gold star. Oh, wait, you look a little bit duller. So here's a gray dot. Well, you don't seem very talented, so here's a gray dot. And the story goes, there was this one toy, and he seemed dull and untalented and not that great to all the other toys. So all that they would ever give him is gray dots. He never got a gold star. And one day he was walking along and he saw this girl. And he realized that this girl had no stars and no gray dots. So he asked her, he said, how is this possible? Well, she goes, well, I go up and I talk to my maker each day and he fixes it. So this little toy had to see what was going on. So he goes up and he sees the maker. He goes and he talks to the maker. And he gets there and he's so ashamed of all his gray dots and all the filth and all the nastiness on him.
Yeah.
And the maker says, no. You don't understand. He's, whoo, that's good stuff.
Come on.
He said, you don't understand. He said, you're my creation. Woo.
Where's he going?
He said, you're my creation. And you're special. He says, you're my creation, and you're special. Oh, Lord, help.
It's good, Noah.
Amen.
It's good, brother.
He says, you're my creation.
She says, and you're specialist for that. And he takes away all those gray dots. And he takes them away. Woo, Lord. And that's why the moment God of our maker. And we're ashamed of all the things that we've been through, everything that we have to put up with.
Bless you, Lord.
We just have to go talk to our maker.
Yeah.
That's right.
And he'll take all that away.
Amen.
Woo. That was good.
That's good stuff.
Amen.
That ain't mine, that's God inspired. That's why that's a good.
Bless
you,
Lord.
So I'd like to end with just a quick recap, if I can see you.
Bless you, Lord.
So first four words, it says, in the beginning, God. So we know that God is in the beginning, and he was the beginning, and he will be there at the end. We know that God is Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. And we also know in the fourth word that God is a big G God. And that big G means something. That means that God is a God placed above all the other little G gods in our life. And we also know that God is a creator, because it says the sixth word is created. And it says in the beginning, or I believe it's the fifth word, excuse me, created is the fifth word. It says in the beginning, God, in the beginning, which is time, God created the heavens and the earth. And we know that that is the Trinity. It's funny that there's another Trinity there. We know that that is a Trinity that all has to happen at one time. We can't have time and matter and no space to put it in. So all these three things have to happen at one time. But if we read the first 10 words of the Bible, it happens all at the same time. And not only do we know that this God who is placed above all other gods is a creator, and he created everything in our known universe. He's not only a skilled creator, but he's a loving creator. Because he loved his creation so much that instead of getting rid of his flawed and messed up, not flawed because he made it flawed because they flawed themselves. Instead of getting rid of that flawed creation, he sent his only begotten son to come down and die on the cross for us so that we could have salvation and be made right again.
Amen.
And I believe that is all that God gave me this morning. And I hope that you got something out of it.
Amen.
I know that I did.
Sure did.
And at this time, I'd like to turn it over to Brother Dwayne.
Bless you, Lord.
Wasn't that something?
Amen.
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 Glad we can go to our Maker.
That's right.
Yes. Amen. Appreciate that. They told me they had a surprise for me this morning. What a pleasant and really good surprise. And Lord, he's done good. I want to say this. I appreciate all of the church. Appreciate your prayers. Appreciate all the folks who've been teaching. And it's been a great blessing, every single lesson. And I'm out of quarantine. And,
amen.
But I still don't have much wind. And still weak, but getting better every day. And I thank the Lord for that.
Amen.
And it certainly was a great blessing just to come in and turn the lights on this morning and just be a part of the service. And want folks to keep praying. Still got a few folks who are sick. Keep praying. We're gonna get better.
That's right.
We're gonna get back in church here hopefully pretty soon, and we're gonna get through all this mess.
Amen.
You can live through
right.
As Trump says, the China virus. I found out.
Amen.
So, but we do thank you for your prayers. And thank you for love and support, all the texts and phone calls. And no, I can't think of a better message this morning than what you brought.
Amen.
And I appreciate it very much.
Amen.
I appreciate it very much. Like I said, every blessing has blessed me. I was watching the Wednesday night and I appreciate that I was able to see it from home. And I just seen something on the news where some folks were just screaming at these elderly folks and calling all kind of names. and just treating them awful. And I was angry. And then I saw and I see what's going on in our country today. And then AJ brought that wonderful message. And boy, it touched my heart. And you know what the world, what they need in return is love. And that's going to be hard to do. But Jesus did say, turn the other cheek, didn't he?
Yeah, man.
But anyway, I just wanted to tell y'all I love you. Love our church. God's going to get us through all this. If he created all this, and he done it perfectly.
Amen.
You know, sometimes what we need to do is go back to our Maker, as he says.
Amen.
And get things fixed up in our heart, and then move forward, and God can bring healing. So
amen.
I'm gonna lead you and leave you with a word of prayer, and I tell you that I do love you. So let's bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your mercy and grace. We thank you for your healing power. We thank you, God, for the great lessons we've heard over the past couple of weeks when we're out sick. We just ask you, Lord, to continue to bless our church, bless all those who are here, those who couldn't be here. I thank you, God, that for this medium of Facebook and YouTube, where we can still do our best to get the gospel of Jesus Christ out. The world needs some good news, and this is where it'll come from. So I pray that you bless each one, heal the sick, save the lost. Lord, keep us where we need to be. I love you and thank you and ask you all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. I love you.